Welcome to our viewers from all over the globe. We're at Stadium Arc de Triomphe in Bucharest, Romania, with the US Eagles set to play their second match of their fall tour. This is the seventh meeting of these two nations, with the United States leading 6-1 against Romania. John Mitchell's Chargers fell to the Maori All Blacks last weekend at Toyota Park 54-7. And the same weekend, Ireland beat the All Blacks for the first time in 111 years. We have four debutants on the squad, 250 caps among them. And this US starting lineup is stacked with a lot of sevens. Eagles set to make their debut today. They're ranked number 17 and Romania are ranked 16th. I'm Dallin Stanford, joined in commentary by former Super Rugby star Mark Stabina. This should be a very interesting tussle against these two great nations.
Should be indeed. Thank you very much, Dallin. What a pleasure to be here, commentating on such a big clash for the US team, especially these two teams fairly evenly matched, particularly in terms of their ranking, 16th versus 17th. So we should be in for a cracker tonight. Really looking forward to it.
And the match this evening, as is customary, will be played for the Pesching Cup. You take a look at the Romanian lineup there, and it is named after General John Pesching, the only U.S. general to be promoted during his lifetime. He received medals by the country of Romania and is considered a hero right here. Romania have had a great season so far in 2016. They're 7-1, including victories over the Argentina 15, and they are led by their big bolstery, number 8, Stelian Burcha.
Romanian team, chock full of experience as well. Got the number 12, 93 caps for Irina Vlaicu. Look out for him, he'll be instrumental tonight, I'm sure.
Todd Kleber leads out the United States Eagles, a record holder for him as well. Kleber earns his 69th cap when he made his debut way back in 2003. A lot of new faces for this team as well. Martin Josefo becomes the 500th Eagle, and what a prestigious night it is for him. Madison Hughes at 15 also makes his debut. The Eagle Sevens captain, both those players fresh from Rio de Janeiro. Meanwhile, Romania, the last time they beat the United States was in 2014 here in Bucharest. They will be looking to cause another upset here in World Rugby's fixture. While the teams get ready, the United States have a match against Tonga next weekend in Spain. We're going to go downstairs in just a few moments for both national anthems. Of course, a great rivalry between these two strong nations. That's referee Paul Williams. He'll be in charge of tonight's fixture as the crowd get ready. Looks like a packed house so far. And we're going to go downstairs in just a few seconds for the national anthems. shot there of the Pershing Cup. Both teams fired up for this clash right now. And of course, the crowd have come into witness. Will be another historical fixture here on home soil for Romania. Head coach John Mitchell said that he's changing the mindset of his team. Take a look at Paul Williams there. He's trying to get... It's not perceived as an invitational side, and the United States are striving for higher standards and more victories in that international jersey. And that's big. Andrew Durtalo there grew up in Suva, Fiji, went to Rio with the Sevens team. Expect a big game from the number eight. Played the Super Rugby with the Sun Wolves. And in picture as well is Joe Tufetti from Pro Rugby, the San Diego Breakers. Most of these players playing overseas. That's Threaten Palamo playing now with Bristol for many years with teammate Taku Nguyen at Biarritz, France. So we're getting underway here. Romania will be kicking off from right to left on your screen, wearing their familiar yellow outfit. And it's that player there who becomes the most capped Romanian player in history with 94 caps, Florin Flaico. And he has scored 731 points, nicknamed the American for having a USA flag on his jersey at his first ever rugby training. And he will get us started here. We're underway. Match number two of the fall tour for the United States Eagles. It comes down. Knocked backwards. Blaine Scully goes in to collect. Lots of pressure on him. Big tackle from Johan van Heerden. And straight away the Romanian pack get involved.
Yes, Dallin. The Romanians making their presence felt straight off the bat. Just the start they would have wanted. They're fired up tonight.
Throwing in Eugen Capatina. 23 caps as the hooker. Take a look at this last little bit there. Scully does well to collect the bouncing ball. And then, of course, the forwards start piling in. We expect to see a lot more of these heavies up front as they set their rolling ball. Romania, such a scrummaging powerhouse. As they take it towards the line.
Advantage for entry.
Ball is still available there. Forwards need to regroup for the USA. Clever there, tussling down at the breakdown.
Use it!
Looking for a few pick and goes. Opening up a bit of space for the forwards to do their work. Now they shift it across field to the back line. Oh, the ball's knocked on just in the process there as Madison Hughes comes in to make a tackle.
Yeah, referee just bringing four. It back. But nonetheless, it was good defense there. You see
number
Palamo
four.
Coming up.
Around the side.
As was Yosefo, putting the pressure on the Romanians, forced the error.
Number four.
However, it'll come back to the original infringement, and Romania have the penalty.
Points. They keep the pressure here on the USA, electing to go for 3 points early on. When points on offer, you must take them. This is Test match rugby.
Yes, Carlo, I can hear you.
Romanian side head coach from Wales, in fact, Lynn Howes. And then he's assisted by Scottish backs coach Rob Muffet. And then Romanian forwards coach Maru Stincu. They'll be eager for their side to extend their record this season to 8-1.
Loku now just lining up the kick. Breeze is behind. Soars him through the blades of grass into the air.
A little bit of wind to speak of. Swirling a little bit at the backs of the Romanians. Flaicu. First played for Romania in 2006. His strike is a nice one, but it stays to the left-hand side of the uprights. So 0-0 the score. The United States will get a 22-meter dropout. Early pressure, early nerves on the kicking duties here of Flaico. So Wild Holder will get us restarted. There's John Mitchell in the middle, head coach, formerly with the All Blacks. Also did a stint with England before they won the Rugby World Cup under Clive Woodward. Ball is kicked upfield. Difficult one to take. It swirls around. Madison Hughes' first touch is an excellent one. The fullback keeps the ball available. Bodies piling everywhere, and the USA come away with possession here.
Great early touch for Madison Hughes on debut tonight. That's how you want to start your first test match for your country. Nice and safe. He's not known for his height, so you can expect the Romanians to pepper him with some high kicks. See if they can get the height advantage over him, but on this occasion, he was rock solid.
Make a mark.
So, 10-minute mark. Joe Tafeti to feed. He started rugby to impress his girlfriend at Balmain Shore, and it certainly worked because they're married now. Set-piece move. Good angled attack here from McFarlane. Bowman comes in to try to clear out some at ruck time. But the big Romanians are on the way. Lazier was there. Now they try to hold up possession. They do superbly. Their captain leading the charge there, Burcha.
Yeah, this is definitely what they're known for, the Romanians. So strong on their feet. It's compulsory to compete in wrestling in middle school in Romania. They're just so strong. Big forward pack. Take it into the rucks and in the contact situation. You need to get your body height low.
We spoke about that forward pack, and here they are right now. First scrum of the game. Romanian front row. 52 caps for Mihai Lazier. And then the other anchor on the other side, Alexandru Tarouș. They're going to reset this. But up the middle as well, vastly experienced. Take a look, there is Coach Howells. Been with this Romanian side for a while right now. He knows they'll be up against it tonight. But of course, playing a home match in Romania is always intimidating. A lot of fans cheering on their side. The Mighty Oaks, as they're known. So, scrum feed coming in from Florin Suruju. 55 caps for the young scrum off. And that goes down again. It's a full-on penalty to Romania.
Yes, Romania just early ascendancy here. Set piece.
Thanks, mate.
Just collapsing there. The US. You can expect the Romanian pack to be a handful at scrum time. They always are, as you mentioned before, Dallin. What a great kick. Getting well deep into the US territory there.
That accuracy is what you need to get points on the board. And Florin Flaiku, he has shown us just that. Danger time here for the United States. Only meters from their try line. Todd Clever is up in the front. Tafeti in the scrum off position. Adds a bit of size up front. They get that rolling maul set. In comes now hooker Capatina. He has it at the back. Maul shifting towards the poles. McFarlane has taken a player out there, but they go for the line.
Advantage.
Romania with advantage. There's space to the left-hand side. Van Heerden, Van Heerden for the line. The big South African will score the first try in this game. And he's absolutely delighted. Johan Van Heerden is over.
Wow, what an opening statement from Romania with the try. It came from the rolling wall from the line out. Started with a massive kick. We mentioned Blykew getting his team in the right part of the field. This was after the driving maul. Great decision from Van Heerden there. Throws the dummy. Blaine Scully trying to thwart the attack by coming through, possibly for an intercept. You'll see again, Scully just racing up. Misses completely, and Van Heerden uses his experience. Great skills for the big man, and a massive long arm as well. That also helps. Try time.
Van Heerden, 14 caps tonight. Joined this Romanian setup earlier in 2015. Played against Tonga in his first test match, and he has been superb for them at set piece. A handful in the loose as well. Big, strong Afrikaans farmer from Nagriqualand West. So a conversion attempt here for Romania, up 5-0, and they've started this match superbly.
They have indeed, Dallin. You see a lot of their forwards. I mean, that's a big feature of their game as well, the driving mauls. Handful of their forwards playing in France. Flaiku now lines up his second attempt at poles tonight.
Another good strike. This time the flags are raised. It's 7-0 Romania lead after 8 minutes against the United States.
Well, the US need to hit back now. You just see that kick. Lovely strike. Just splits the poles right through the middle.
Deep kickoff from Holder. Romania get a chance to look at their exit strategy. Put a nice high hanging kick up here. Goes quite far, in fact, and Scully puts it to the boot.
Stop.
Goes down the middle of the field, though. So an attacking opportunity here for Furku. He puts his kick in down towards Madison Hughes. This may go a bit too far. And Hughes, the second touch of his international career here in 15s with much less pressure.
That's right, Dallin. Nice composure from Hughes, just wheeling that ball into the in-goal area, taking his time. Kick from the 15, Furku. You mentioned the breeze behind the Romanians. You need to just take a little sting off those kicks.
Holder goes down the middle, gives attacking opportunities both sides for the Romanians. Put up another kick by Flaiku. Oh, this is a high hanging one, swirling in the wind. Hughes can't get this one. Bounces everywhere. Finally picked up from Big Lazar, and he throws it back in field. Excellent work here from Lukic. In support, Romania back on attack. Little box kick over the top. There's a race. This could be the second try of the game. He is over. Catalin Furku, in his 91st game for his country, scores try number two.
What a quick hit back there. Two from two, Romania. It all started with that kick, Dallin, we mentioned before. Madison Hughes safe under the first high ball, but the second one he was unable to pull it in, and you see as a result of that, lovely little deft kick from the nine. Florin Suruju, and that man, that 15, I suspect it was a little set move from the two of them. Good communication, wins the race over Scully, pulls it in nicely. What a great try for Romania.
Yeah, the bounce of the ball has been all Romania this time. They're keeping it in the corners as well with tactical kicks. And all of a sudden, after 10 and a half minutes, it's 12-0. The United States have hardly touched possession. And you've got to feel they're a bit shell-shocked right now. As we take a look at that try scorer. Try number 30 for Furku. Conversion attempt from Flaiku. Taking his time on this one. Romania relishing the opportunity to play the United States. The kick goes wide, but they are leading handsomely at 12-0.
Certainly are. Vlaiku unable to add the extras, just leaning back a little bit on that kick. Just pushing it out to the right. But what a great start, once again, from Romania. USA need to hit back immediately.
Will Holder, this time, has put a bit too much weight on that kick. It goes out on the full. So the Romanians will take possession in what we call an unforced error.
Absolutely, possibly a little shell-shocked right now, the US. Romania scoring 12 points in as many minutes. As we come back to the halfway, in the middle of the field for a scrum. A good attacking opportunity. Nice solid base will be set for their backs from the Romanian pack, I'm sure.
Take a look there. Clever on the left of your screen, wearing 7, McFarlane 8. Clever has been one of the most prolific rugby players for the United States. The first player to ever play Super Rugby. And then a stint in Japan as well, winning some championship titles there. Also in the United Kingdom recently, and now he's in Austin, Texas at the Huns organization. And launching more professional rugby, which is very important in the USA to develop the players. Well, Chris Bowman will be tested up front again. Will Titi Lamasatelli, the youngest Eagle to be capped at 18 years of age, played in the Rugby World Cup in 2015. Better scrum this time from the front row forwards. In a rare time, you'll see the Romanians on their backs.
You can see Chris Bowman before just doing the right thing, making sure he was set properly. We get a solid platform. Much better scrum, as you mentioned, Dallin, for the US. They're certainly up against it tonight.
Lamasatelli, you saw him in screen there. The player to watch for the 2019 Rugby World Cup. Also a wrestler, which will be much needed against this Romanian pack. A lot of grappling going on there. All right, Romania. No, the scrum collapses yet again. What this does do is soak up a bit of time here for the Romanians to enjoy their lead so far.
Listening. Hold our weights here, boys. We need more height today.
Look at that Romanian front row. What a menacing pack.
Please come to me.
I'd certainly hate to be facing them. Well, hate to be in the front row in general, Dallin, but certainly against this motley crew here. Big, strong. I've played with some Romanians in my career. And they are tough customers.
Closest to our side here, we've got Lazar, and on the far side, Tarush. So let's see if the scrum can be taken cleanly. It is coming down the Romanian side. At the back, picked up there by Captain Bushka. In fact, controlled by his foot. Trevor's got to be careful for coming offside. They've detached from the scrum, so it's a penalty for Romania. Scrum woes continue for the United States.
Going around. Must stay straight.
You can see the Romanians just congratulating themselves.
Shot.
Just continuing to pile on the pressure here, as they've indicated.
They must still stay straight.
We'll try for another 3 points. Nearly 50 metres out. That's a difficult attempt. Vlaicu isn't exactly on form with his kicks. Let's see what he can do here, and he can put his team further in front at 15 points to nil.
Well, I think he's going to try to prove us commentators wrong. Vlaicu lines this one up. So the United States, though, we haven't mentioned a lot of their names yet. We've got Bryce Campbell on debut in the centres. Had a great USA Selects tour to Argentina. In fact, it was Uruguay. And then Madison Hughes at 15. Been involved early on the bench. A couple more debutants as well for the USA. Meanwhile, it's Romania. Penalty attempt from near the halfway line. Vlaicu. Oh, he puts some good weight behind this one. It is over. Take that, he says, Mark Stabina. And all of a sudden, Romania 15-0 ahead.
Well, that's the last time I doubt anyone on this pitch. Great kick. You can see Vlaicu there just taking his time, a little bit more time with that kick. A couple of deep breaths, line it up really nicely. Certainly no problem with the distance, especially with this breeze.
Holder's kick is into the 22.
Six.
Returned
Stop.
With interest.
Stop.
Durotalo is back there helping out.
Yes.
Fluent in three languages.
Blue, keep moving.
None of which is English, though. As Holder puts it up. Chases nicely, but a little breakout here for Romania. Get their big, hard-working forwards involved as well, and that is Marus Antonescu. And now they take it up through Lukac. Defetti tries to get this one turned over. Loses his balance, though. Now stabbed through the boot. A little clever kick. Hughes is there. Read that superbly. Oh, great little sidestepping from Madison Hughes. Born in London, England. Now applying his trade in the American jersey. Formerly with Dartmouth as well, as big threat in Palermo. Also one of the young stars, capped at a very early age. It's a flat ball and a hammering tackle there. Looks like Bowman got a haircut in that hit. And so Romania capitalized on this. Up the middle they go. The ball's been stolen by Newcap.
Knock on by three blue.
Savetta. In fact, Brakely was in there. But they're going to come back for Romanian possession.
You see that flat pass. Any flatter and it was forward.
Yeah.
Possibly that's what put the pressure on. For Chris Bowman coming in.
On the side.
Romanian defense just solid. Moving up quick. They're quick off the line. They like to put pressure on. Force the errors just as they've done there. But that USA attack all started with great little play from Madison Hughes, the debutant, coming through confidently. A little stab in behind. You see the Romanians testing the US defense and testing the back three constantly with high kicks, low kicks. So obviously that's part of their game plan tonight, but Madison Hughes up to the task.
Here's Madison Hughes, turned 24 last month. Such a young up-and-coming player. And then captained the team in Rio de Janeiro.
Yep.
Take a last look at this replay. Augsburger gets involved there, and it is Nate Brakely. Rips that ball free. Very strong stuff from the man from the New York Athletic Club. Got his first cap in the RSC against Canada earlier this year.
And don't you love to see your scrum halves just getting stuck in like that, Dallin? Great hit from Augsburger on a guy nearly twice his size.
Well, Augsburger's an East Coast man. No nonsense scrum half. He does his talking in actions. The man from Old Blue of New York. Also with the Northeast Olympic Development Academy. I like the look of Augsburger here at number nine as well. This scrum is going to reset yet again. Todd Clever is asking referee Williams.
I'm looking you two here.
About a potential penalty against Romania.
I'm coming this side. Let's go.
Todd did a bit of acting in Hollywood in his early years. Now he's based in San Diego. Romania up 15-0. Almost 20 minutes gone in this first half. We're here in Bucharest, Romania. This time a better shove from the Romanian side. Clever wants to get free. Waiku puts it to the boot, keeping the pressure down here in the United States territory. And it goes all the way through the back. So they're going to come back from where they kicked it. Just a bit too much foot on that one.
Yes, Dallin's the second time we've seen Romania just overcooking the kick a little bit. The first one was from the fullback, Catalin Furcu this time, and number 12, Vlaicu. Both of them with equally big boots on them. You just need to take the sting off them a little bit. It's now US breathe a sigh of relief, and they get a nice attacking opportunity for the first time in a while.
Let's see if Duratolo can get this at the back. Options, as you said, left and right. We've got Madison Hughes and Will Holder. Both can take it in the fly position. Scrum. Channeling in from the side, looks like it. Ball came out the tunnel, said referee, so they're going to reset.
Scrum.
A couple of pushes and shoves. McFarlane gets involved.
Ball came out the same channel. Scrum. Blue ball, it came out the same channel.
As you said, all this scrum resetting, chewing up valuable time that the US want and need to get themselves back into this game and on the scoreboard.
You've got to feel they've got to get all their players get a touch on the ball properly. Haven't seen Martin Josefo yet, Mr. Olympia.
Set.
With the Denver Barbarians out of the University of Montana, one of the best players to come out of that area. Now Duratolo does get it cleanly. They shift it across to Hughes. A little bit of space for the fullback. Scully comes back in field. Wayne Scully, one of the co-captains of this team, just a wonderful character on and off. The US set a few rucks, spreading the field right now. It's Bowman up in midfield. He gets knocked backwards as half gap opens up for Augsburger. He needs support right now. Furcu has him. Brakely in there to play halfback. And Bowman yet again. He's really coming alive. The man playing rugby in Wellington, New Zealand. Offside play. Got to be. Advantage here. New cap Savetta. Celebrated his 27th birthday last week. Wouldn't he love to get over the try line? As Duratolo smashes it up into the traffic. Turnover though. Romania have stopped a sure attack here from the USA and launching one of their own right now. Lachlan coming in as Scully goes in to collect this. And it'll just come back for a scrum feed to the United States.
The US just squandering a great attacking opportunity there. Much better play from the US. Playing very flat in attack as well. Putting pressure on the defense by putting pressure on themselves. It's been tough to handle the ball with such big hits coming in for the Romanians, but they held firm until just that turnover there moments before this play here. Luckily for the US, they didn't have the numbers. Romania had plenty, but they were just a little flat in attack, couldn't handle the pass. As the US now can regroup, getting some confidence from their last little passage of play. Nate Augsburger just sniping around the ruck there. Great vision from him to get his team moving forward. He made about 10 meters there, which got them on the front foot. So he'll be looking to maybe do the same thing as the game progresses.
Yep, that's the angry Romanian pack getting ready. Mentioned Blaine Scully earlier, one of the co-captains, one of the most experienced backline players here for the USA. He is with the Cardiff Blues right now, formerly with the Leicester Tigers. 32 caps for the All-American from Cal. And that's Manu Samoa. Samu Manoa will love to take the field soon. He can certainly bring the shoulder as well. Bench is packed with some newer players, but then some veterans as well. Eric Fry is on the bench as well, called to cover the front row position. He's with the Newcastle Falcons. He'll look to earn his 41st cap later today. So Nate Orsberger, another attacking chance here for the USA.
Set! 9-9!
He'll be watching the scrum closely, the forwards coach for the Eagles. So they get a loop around with Orsberger, and Holder ships it wide. Palamo can move. Quick hands, and then finally makes its way to the outside, but the Romanians have infringed.
Offside.
Some fancy play there by the USA back line.
Nine.
Some looping moves, offside. A couple of decoy runners as well. But the Romanians, they defended well. They shifted quickly and weren't too sucked in by all the different running angles coming in from the USA runners, and they were able to drift out. Cover the US attack quite easily. Mason Hughes coming into the line, not with a lot of room. Shifted the ball on quickly for a bounce pass. But nonetheless, comes back to the original infringement, and the US yet again in a good attacking opportunity here, Dallin.
24-year-old Tafeti, born in American Samoa. He will throw. Earns his eighth cap tonight. And from Long Beach, California as well. Spent a lot of time there. Now they attack the line, very flat again, as you mentioned. Campbell onto this, the debutant. Now Tafeti steaming on at real speed, and that ball has just knocked forward. Looking promising there for the Eagles.
Well, that's unfortunate for Joe Tafeti, and a little uncharacteristic as well. Such a skillful player for a hooker. Coming in, just bobbling the ball there. And again, just that flat attack playing right on the Romanian defense. Put you under a lot of pressure. Handling skills need to be up to par. Tafeti there normally is on this occasion. Again, just another good attacking opportunity goes begging for the US.
15-0, 25 minutes gone. Slight injury on the ground as the Romanian staff get involved there.
Okay.
You mentioned such a good record for them so far in 2016. Okay. 7-1, including a win over the Argentinian 15 side. The Mighty Oaks rank 16th in the world. Competitions like this are so few and far between. The United States will move on to Spain next weekend and play Tonga. And that will be another very, very physical game. A couple of haymakers and a couple of high hits as well.
Last scrum, very good.
Absolutely, Dallin, and this is just the game to warm up for a physical encounter like that. The Romanians not holding back.
Set!
Scrum midfield. Romania will look to clear their lines. Got some great kickers on their team. Ball spits free. They stab this one downfield. Not as far as they would have hoped. Actually, they do pick up good territory right near the halfway line. And so the US will now have to regroup.
Todd.
That's not a bad exit strategy from Romania there, just off the scrum. Blaiku was able to thread the ball and get it nearly up to the halfway line. The US still in Romania territory.
That lineout wasn't straight from Tafeti, right at the back.
Option, Stella.
Another chance goes a begging.
Lineouts.
Masar Braki there, formerly with the Western Force from University of Cape Town, my neck of the woods in South Africa, now with the US Eagles, born in Los Angeles. Like to see if he gets a look later at this squad. John Mitchell has rotated some of his players around. It blooded a lot of new talent in the ARC competition earlier year. Had an opportunity in the summer as well. Play Russia and Italy. So Romania back on attack. Take it to the midfield. Looking for Vlaiko to do some damage, and he's doing just that. Palomo brings him down. Then they get some of their big warhorses in Lazier. made his debut in 2008. A real menace up front. Slow ball here for the big Romanian Oaks. Marus Antonescu. Bowman with a good solid bit of defense. Now stab over the top. Scully takes this one beautifully. Holder on attack. And then funneled into touch into the advertising boards. Big collision there. And a few handbags pulled out as well.
Just stand back.
Largy Bargy here over the sideline. Romanians trying to intimidate. They're full of confidence right now. 15-0 on the scoreboard. Throwing everything at the USA Eagles team. Once again, just Scully did so well to bring that ball in. Holder didn't have much opportunity at all. He was under pressure from the time he got the ball.
Listen, use your head, please.
But yet again, Dallin just peppering the US back three.
Stay off him in the air,
little kicks
please.
In behind. That's an obvious tactic coming into this game. Try and turn the US defense around, but also make a tough night of it for the US back three.
The Romanians Stella, are certainly
are
doing
you
that.
In or out? Thank you.
Capatina goes to the front. He's got Van Heerden with him.
Yes,
the rolling ball inches forward. Vasily Rus.
No!
Right near the 22. Romania up by those 15 points. As Bowman comes in.
Fine.
Ball busts free. And just a knock-on creeping in there. The US doing a lot of defending in the end zone.
They are indeed. Lucky break there from the US. Romania once again looking strong. Piling through on the rucks there. And we just see a stitch tackle there from Brakely. Dislodging the ball of the Romanian scrum half, Florin Sarugiu. USA live to fight another day. Let's see if they can get out of their red zone.
Yeah, Brakely, he was a standout at Dartmouth. And now with the New York Athletic Club, he won two CRC competitions. He teams up with debutant Nick Savetta today. Savetta was at Notre Dame, and he returns to the United Kingdom after today's match with the Newcastle Falcons. Durotalo has it at the back. Full of running is big. Andrew Durotalo, look at him go. Looking like he's back on the Sevens World Series. Ball goes to Romania, and they step through a bit of traffic. Excellent run down the touchline. Here they go. Looking for the offload. Hughes tries to get in the way. But what a break it was from Catalin Fercu.
No!
The US looking to clear their lines right now. Preventing would look like another near try attempt as Osberger Kitts goes over the 22.
Wow, it was indeed. That was real danger territory. It was Durotalo who made a great break from the scrum and then just insisted on pushing the pass. It was a 50-50, if that, to Scully on the right-hand side. He was heavily marked. Ended up turning it over, and then so much room for that man there just to slice through, bring his team all the way back, nearly to 10 metres from the USA try line.
Pressure is mounting. Capatina knows that.
Stop.
Keep hammering away and the line breaks will come. Good tackle though at the advantage line. Flaiku, now they come the short side. Rustling through there. Serraju. Ball picked up mid-ruck. Still the hammer forward with Van Heerden. Now they go to that short side. In there as well is Tarus. Dropping the shoulder. Romania bringing the heat here. 10 minutes to go in this first half. Looking for their third try. They will get a penalty.
It's all Romania at the moment. I like how they're mixing up their play, Dallin. They're really showing they've got quite a few weapons in the armory. They've got the kicks in behind. They've got the rucking, they've got the mauling. Big forward pack, making some good yards on this USA team. And then they've actually got some quite skillful backs that are reaching the gain line nicely, a couple of breaks early before. This is a tough Romanian side. USA struggling a little bit right now.
Romania has a very rich history on the rugby field. I actually remember watching them 21 years ago at Newlands in Cape Town, South Africa. Rugby World Cup, They played South Africa, who eventually won the competition and only lost 20 points to 8. The hallmark of the game was their forward pack. And you can see that's continued decades later as they look for another try. Clever is up front, trying to fool some of the folks there. And it's worked. It's not straight.
Not straight.
You've seen a couple of throws not straight tonight from both teams. Taufete struggling a little bit to find the back of the line out. I suspect with this breeze, it's causing a little bit of havoc in the hookers' minds.
Numbers.
Just definitely on the Romanian side there.
Taufete needs to get it out this time. He finds Saveda. And then Holder's kick goes over the 22. No chance of a quick one. But they're still inside the 22.
Yes, Romania piling on all the pressure here yet again. So dangerous to get into this part of the field. You can bet your bottom dollar they're going to use this forward pack to full advantage.
Right, you saw the Eagle squad on the sideline there. Cam Dolan with his twin brother next to him. And now Romania, very flat ball, and Blaiku gets the offload superbly away to his outside center. Jack Umanga earns his fourth cap today. Comes from a strong rugby playing family with Tano Umanga and the family. The cut-out pass is a good one. Romania search for the line. Nothing Scully can do. Looks like they're over here. Fiorel Lukac celebrates what could be his ninth try for his country. And Romania put another one over.
Wow, Romania, look at that crowd going wild, as they should. You see, this is the last part of the play. Numbers out to the left for Romania. Scully had a lot to do. Dug the shoulder in. That's a tough tackle for him to make on a guy that probably has 20 or 30 pounds on him. Gets in with the right shoulder, drives, but the damage was done. You see here, big Lukac. Very, very tough to stop from that position there. Just awaiting now, though. The referee has called for TMO's consultation on this. Don't we just cast our minds back a couple of phases before, which led to that position there for the Romanians. Vlaicu, such a big man, and remember, 93 caps under his belt. This is his 94th. He's been testing the channel of Holder all night with some relative success in that case. Got his team well over the advantage line, which put them on the front foot, and then just numbers to burn back on the left-hand side.
And Williams just making sure, Referee Williams, of this grounding here. Is his pink rugby cleats, were they on the line? No, they're in. Ooh, very close. That's why they're having a few looks at this. Try or no try?
Just wait. Yes. Yes. Just confirming I may award the try. Thank you.
And it is a try indeed, Dallin. Try to Romania. That's 20 points to nil. TMO thinks that the big man, Lukac, kept the whole body in play despite the best efforts of Blaine Scully.
And Romania, as we said, their forwards have worked superbly all night so far in this first half. Their backs have added some clever interplay, and of course it's the boot of Vlaicu that has certainly helped his side with their wins at their backs. 6 minutes to go in the first half, they're up by 20 points, and this Romanian side is not to be underestimated. Play very tough competition locally. Vlaicu should be a good contender for Movember. Another big strike. The kick just aims to the left-hand side. So it's Romania that keep the scoreboard ticking against the United States.
Yeah, the United States very shell-shocked right now, probably wondering what's going on.
Very difficult to get the ball back. As you see, Rose puts this kick downfield. Jody Rose, nice kick.
I need you to stop.
Well back there. Dertala wants to go quickly, but they've come flying up. Very frustrated looking big number eight there.
You see, Dallin, just with 20 points on the scoreboard, I have to say, I feel like Romania's a little bit more clinical tonight. That's the difference between the two teams.
Three.
Taking their opportunities when they get them, more so than the U.S. team.
Yep, Tafeti, this group is only assembled just before the Maori All Black game last weekend. They will get better as the tour gets on, one would
Blue,
hope.
Stop.
And now this kick,
yes.
Bit of a nothing kick that.
Fair challenge.
Scully does his best to collect, but you've got to feel they've got to keep ball in hand, especially down by three tries.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. The tactic was to maybe put it high and force a 50-50, perhaps get the ball back. But if the U.S. can just keep the ball in hand and run through the phases, Romania tends to be an ill-disciplined team. They can get frustrated if you keep the ball away from them.
And we said how many seven stars they've got. The creativity is there. The speed is at hand. And Osberger gets this one away. And who's standing at first receiver? They take it to the advantage line to the USA. Durotalo is in there as well. They've got all the playmakers. And that's one of them right now. Holder tries to dummy his way through. Threatens the line. That's what you want from a fly off. I want to see Martin Josefa with more ball in hand.
Leave him.
500th U.S. Eagle as Osberger goes quickly. Surely they were not 10 meters. Referee says play on. And now the stab through. This is actually a good kick. It keeps Romania under pressure. A few meters from their own try line.
Yeah, great execution there from Holder. Spotted the gap from his team deep into Romanian territory. Can't help but thinking, as we mentioned before, you just want to keep the ball in hand. Kind of went against that philosophy, but nonetheless, he's piled the pressure right onto Romania now with such a well-weighted kick.
So the home side need to be accurate here in their line-out. Hotly contested there by Brakely.
Five!
And the box kick into touch. Now gives an opportunity to the USA as this first half winds down.
Thank you.
So once again, you just see fruits of Holder's efforts before with that kick. As you said, Dallin, putting the pressure on Romania at the right end of the field, and now they've come up with the ball. Fantastic attacking opportunity here for the U.S. They need to do something with it and get themselves on the scoreboard.
Tafeti goes to the back. This time his throw is a good one. Lamasa Taylor is in there as well. Now they drive forward a few extra meters. Savetta. Ball spits free, though, for Osberger to clean up. And then
backwards.
Knocked on. Referee says went backwards, but Romania have taken this ball and kicked it downfield as Bowman charges it. Romania find themselves in a little bit of pressure right now. Their captain, Burcha, does very well and well supported also from Antonescu.
Held up.
It's going to come the way for the USA, though. Find that attacking lines are very flat. You mentioned earlier, Mark, and it's so tough to get go forward ball when you're knocking it on.
Absolutely. With a team like Romania that defends up in your face like that with massive hits, you might just want to take a step back. Well, I'm all for putting pressure on the defense by playing close to it. It's very hard to change angle if you slice through right on the defensive line. But things are just a little loose for the moment.
No,
go back to that line out and the drive
go?
From the U.S. Need to tighten things up a little, and as you mentioned, they've come together pretty late. That could be a feature of that. It takes time to force combinations, even when you do driving laws like that, just to tighten things up. The ball spat out the back, and then it was just a bit of a bobble thing, but they come up with the ball now. Another attacking opportunity.
Yeah, head coach John Mitchell, so experienced, was with the All Blacks 2001 and 2003, the youngest ever head coach there. Also with England under Clive Woodward when they won the World Cup. So his charges continue. Nice little loop around there. Better stuff from the U.S. They come wide, though. And just into touch. Got a feel, though, as well. Maybe a switch, perhaps, to bring that back in field. Scully is a talented player, but he needs room to operate.
Yeah, the play might have looked nice and fancy, bamboozling, but didn't bamboozle Romania at all.
Runners
coming in there. Ineffective.
Good
defense. You've got to give the credit to Romania. Just covered that really well. Wayne Scully got the ball with no room to move at all.
Time back off.
It all came from just an ineffective dummy runner in close.
HIO.
Okay. Might have looked nice, but the Romanians were not falling for any of it, Dallin.
Strong defense from them. Kept the U.S. scoreless so far. We're now to the last little bit of the first half. Jeffrey Williams just checking the watch, making sure no more off-field incidents as Romania replaced one of their players.
Yeah, we're waiting. We're waiting. We're just waiting for a substitution. Just a second.
So there is time for one more play.
No. In the last play.
And coming onto the field right now is Stephen Shannon, earning his seventh cap. His debut earlier this year. Romania go to the front.
On the field now.
The drive has worked superbly, and then they just put it out. And that will bring us to halftime here at Bucharest, Romania, as the home side have scored three tries, and they lead the United States by 20-0. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to bring you the second half coming up very soon. It's Romania 20, the USA 0. About to get underway here at the beautiful Stadium Arc de Triomphe in Bucharest, Romania. And it is the home side that have scored three excellent tries. They lead the United States 20-0. Romania ranked 16th in the world against the United States ranked 17th. I'm Dallin Sanford, joined alongside former Super Rugby star Mark Stabina. It's been a very interesting tussle in the first 40.
Thank you, Dallin. It has indeed. Being all Romania, obviously, on the scoreboard, 20-0, it's a shutout. And I just feel like the Romanians are really using their opportunities well, a little bit more clinical than the U.S. team. The U.S. have showed flashes of some good play, and just get the feeling if they can hold on to the ball, you'll see them make some inroads against this Romanian team. We've already seen some signs of frustration with the Romanians when they don't have the ball for a certain amount of time. They like to get in there and push the boundaries and try and get the ball back, giving away penalties. The USA needs to be aware of this and just keep the ball in hand.
All is in readiness right now. Paul Williams, the referee, the man in the middle. And look out for Romania in yellow, the Mighty Oaks. They should be on the left of your screen. The United States will be kicking off with Will Holder. Holder made his debut in 2012 against Canada. And inspired by his father to play rugby. Always loved that story. 3 years of age. So, second 40. We're underway here in Bucharest. And straight off from the start, a breakout here for Romania. Good skills in the end. They keep this one alive. And it was Fonavai Tangemana, who had that earlier. Now they range it up with some of the big forwards. Savetta asked to make the tackle. As
stop two.
Holder gets knocked off to that kick. Goes straight into touch. Got to be careful there. Dangerous collision.
Yeah, crunching hit on Holder. You can see him appealing to the referee on his knees. Thought it was a late hit. Could that man there on the ground have gotten out of the way? Tangemana, we'll see now. Say it was pretty tough when he was already committed, Dallin. Mm-hmm. Kicks well. Nice little box kick there. Well fielded by Holder.
Yeah, Tangemana making his debut as well here for Romania. The US have four debutants starting. A few more on the bench as well. Go to the back. Ball slapped down. Difficult one to take for the Nagri halfback. Suruju does well though. Now they send some of their runners. Vasily Urus winning his 14th cap. Onescu. Now flat attack. They're off for the switch. Initially a good one, and then the U.S. capitalized with this, and Madison Hughes out in a bit of open space. He gets his pass away.
Tackler release!
Defense though, wow, just solid. A lot of numbers there to the breakdown. The U.S. look outnumbered when they take it upfield. McFarlane Hughes tries to get the quick pass. Might have been knocked back by a Romanian hand. Scully tries to clean things up. Oh, Blaine Scully, what a break. The co-captain drops a shoulder. Running people over. Don't blame it on the Scully, they say. As the Eagles go to the far side. Campbell. Now Lamasatelli. He's driven backwards. Floating pass up here for Yosefo. Martin Yosefo, the 500th Eagle. Gives it to Clever. Ball's knocked on. Looking very promising there for the USA. Yosefo with a bit of injection as well.
Promising indeed. Great little phase of play from the US. Finally, ball in hand, as we mentioned before. They kept it. Nice hands there from Yosefo. Clever coming in. Great support from him, but just trying to get the arm free for maybe an offload. Pushing it a little bit. It was very, very encouraging play leading up to that. It all started with a good counter-attack from the turnover. Madison Hughes, it was, launching to the right-hand side. They're a potent back line when they get some room. And Scully, I mean, he had no right to get through. Two, three, four defenders in the end. Fantastic play.
Blaine Scully, one of our favorite players. Such a gentleman on off the field. Take a last look at this. Clever just couldn't hold on to that. Tell you why Todd has played so much rugby. He's bandaging those fingers together. Probably only got three left on each hand, but still soldiers on. A couple of injury concerns here, but the US are right back in this territory-wise. They need to get on that scoreboard very soon. Can't give an international team 20 points at the half.
Oh, I feel you can just sense that the US know it as well. They know that they can just keep hold of it. They'll be the first to score, and they also know that they need to be the first to score as well to get back in this game.
It all starts with a set piece.
Catch! Fine!
Romania's exit strategy has been very good. Kicking out of the end zone. We just need to keep this scrum up. We'll do a better job this time. They'll give away three penalties. Romania attack the line, dropping the shoulder. They do concede a penalty to Romania, but, well, Tangi Mana into the line. He's going to be a danger as he gets more experience at international level.
He's a danger, and once again, you saw the channel that he was attacking, Holder's channel. Trying to test out the fly half. But in this occasion, he doesn't hold back. Gets the shoulder in. A bit of a speed bump there in the end, Holder, but at least he slowed him down. And the original penalty coming back. Such a big, tough man, pumping the legs, taking three men just to get him down.
Tafeti throws a good one, goes to the back, sets the Eagles on a rolling maul.
Middle.
Clever is in the thick of things there as well.
Nine, once, going backwards.
US not making any real ground. We get another full-on penalty, tap quickly, certainly not 10. Going for the line, should be another penalty here. And might even be a yellow card. Let's listen.
Offside. 10 metres, please, on the line.
No yellow cards, but the penalty indeed. Just look here. Ball. A little rushed from Augsburger. Very flat. Too hard for Clever to bring it in.
And Romania could see another penalty in the red zone. Tafeti goes to the back yet again. Taken nicely there. They drive for the line. Tafeti in the thick of things. Joe Tafeti going for the line. He's over. Is he down on the ground? Romanian bodies everywhere. Referee will take a look at this.
Easy.
Well, much better effort from that US forward pack. Driving in, trying to play Romania at their own game. You just see here. Clever leading the charge. Ball's at the back. Romanian jerseys everywhere. We've had to back that one in for an easy grounding, but referee, he's not convinced.
Water off.
He's calling held up straight away. Has he gone to his TMO at all? I think he's made that decision. You can see that there from that angle.
Stable.
Definitely held up.
Stable.
Great tackle. Not sure who it is underneath there, but I saw a hint of yellow. But nonetheless, still, the US with the ball 5 meters out from the Romanian line.
Fine. Set.
Nate Orsberger. Looking to snipe around the fringes. Giotolo's at the back. He picks this one up. Gets the fend on. Deverin to help out. Eagles so close to the try line.
Onside!
And Manoa's on the field right now. Samu Manoa, wearing 19. He's a big unit. They come wide to Tafeti. Tafeti puts his shoulder down. Gets met with another firm tackle. Again, it's that debutant with a flying arm there. Tangamana. Manoa again surges for the line. He's now with the Toulon club in France. Duratalo is so close. Desperate times here for the Romanians on defense. The USA hammering at the line. Another advantage. Osberger looking to see what option is going to be the best one. They come to Holder, flinging it wide. And now Scully. Scully drops down. Ball is still in the field of play. They've done superbly. Oh, but the Romanians just barreling people in touch. Wrestle throwing them as well.
Well, prime opportunity for the US team. Still unable to get over that Romanian try line. Fantastic defensive effort from the Oaks. Todd Clever receiving some attention there. There's a pile of bodies in that last ruck. Looked like he fell awkwardly as well when he came into support.
Your players not rolling away. Okay? Yep. They made the tackle. They must need more away. Here. Okay? No. Short. Time off.
So the referee bringing it back.
Huh? Not rolling away.
Have a look at that replay here, Dallin. This is where Todd Clever suffered. There it is, right there. You see the knee coming in from the number 12, Romanian Lycu. He's a big man with big knees. You don't want that at the back of your head.
Todd Clever. Take your time.
He's on the receiving end. But as you mentioned, three fingers each hand and a tough skull. He's back on his feet and straight back into it. What a soldier.
JP Iloff, he's frustrated on the sideline there. But Clever back on the field. He is a warrior. Made his debut 13 years ago and still leading the country. The US need to strike now. McFarlane, he's ready.
Substitution.
Good to see Samu Manoa on the field as well.
Yeah.
The big beast. He really will add some go forward momentum.
He can come on.
Absolutely. And the US need to be careful not to get frustrated too. Just. Remain composed, keep playing the way they're playing, and the Romanians are sure to crack. No panic play, just know. They just keep playing to their patterns, ball in hands, remain clinical. And they're sure to be the first team to score in this second half.
Coming on the field there shortly is Langi Apiakua, just known as Langi Langi. He made his name in pro rugby with the San Diego side. Debuted against Russia in 2016 in June. He'll be another impact player off the bench. Much needed here against this big, big forward pack of Romania. So the US piling on the pressure. Romania better be careful as well not to concede a yellow. This time the scrum pops up, so they're going to have to reset.
It's been a theme of this whole match, hasn't it?
Both front rows up.
Again, just running that clock down. US desperate just to get on with it and get themselves on the scoreboard. They're back into this game. The Romanians. They're holding firm right now. Some great defense. Just, again, more time. Ticking away, Dallin.
That is right. Frustrating for coaches watching. Phil Greening, the defense coach. Mike Friday doing the attack. Both those two coaches are obviously involved in the US Sevens program as well. Marty Veal with the forwards and Rob Hoadley with the backs. They'll be seeing how they can improve as this tour gets on, all in preparation for the 2019 Rugby World Cup, which takes place in Japan. It starts by getting back on the scoreboard in big games like these. See End of the night for big Romanian front rower Lazier. He's certainly been tough in the front, and Papakui Lange Lange certainly about to take the field, wearing that American scrum cap of his for his second cap. And 10 minutes gone in the second half, still 20-0. USA suffering three early first half tries. But in a great attacking platform here, you look at Josefo there, just on the left-hand side of Holder. Defense will have to honor Josefo as Dortalo picks up at the back. Campbell comes in to help him out. Eagles one quick ball. It stays with the forward pack. Bauman is in there as well to clean things up. And now they attack the gain line yet again. Olsberger thinks about bringing to the backs and then sets the forwards for another run. Ramosatelli. They get yet another penalty. A tap and go. They're only 1 meter back. There should be a certain yellow card. It starts to take its toll on the Romanian defense. Durotalo for the line.
Onside.
Now behind the back it comes to Palamo. Palamo has knocked that one on, but this will be yet another penalty 5 meters out.
You saw the Romanians there just creeping offside. We can see it from one of the camera angles, number 12 in particular. That's what they're trying to do, come up and just swarm the USA attack. Nate Ortsberger doing a great job of just lifting the pace of the game, quick taps here and there. Who knows, that's the way you need to play Romania. Get yourselves on the scoreboard, frustrate them. And they're doing that. As we mentioned before, Dallin, they're holding the ball well now, and you see Romania will just get frustrated. They'll start to infringe, and their discipline goes down the toilet. So, but still, still holding out USA.
They go to the back. Another rolling maul. First one went over the try line, but was held up. So the USA with Durotalo at the back. Romania holding on for dear life. So close to the line. Bauman is in there. And now it comes for a short ball. Campbell takes it upfield. Now Holder with a bit of space. Will Holder searching for the line. He's got it. Holder scores the first try for the USA. And how fitting, a day after Veterans Day, Will Holder with the United States Military Academy is over the try line.
Great work, Holder. And great work, the Eagles. Perseverance paying off here. A couple of phases there, Holder. Just keeping the ball in two hands, assessing his options. The Romanian defense just shoots up all over the place in sixes and sevens. Plenty of gaps there for Holder just to sneak through and dot down. Nice and close to the post as well, so should make the conversion nice and easy. But that was just the result of some great build-up play from the US, piling the pressure onto Romania. It seems like they've been in that zone for about 6 or 7 minutes. So it was bound to happen, Dallin.
And a kick just creeps in there from Holder. It is 7 points finally on the board for the United States. And finally, they're back in this match. 53 minutes gone, and Will Holder has added seven. Romania still lead by 20. 20-7. Look at that kick, just curls in. A little pressure as well coming in. They've got to feel like that attack just slightly deeper is giving them more opportunity to see what's in front.
Absolutely, Dallin. What would be interesting now is just to see the body language of the two teams. Now that the US have hit back and they're on the scoreboard, we'll see what kind of confidence they play with now and the style of play that they employ, and what Romania will do in response as well.
So Lange Lange is on the field. He's wearing 20 for the USA, and also number 20 for Romania is on, and that's Andre Gorchoia. Lange Lange, football standout San Mateo. And now we've got a professional contract at rugby with the Glasgow Warriors. This one comes down to the forward pack down the far side. Forsberger's box kick floats towards the side of the field, and good pickup there from Ferku. Romania to the short side, they go. Tarouche just probing with some of their big heavies. Lionel Baju, wearing 17, is on the field. Flat Eagles defense, they come flying up. Romania to the halfway line. US fairly organized on defense right now. Romania going side to side. Ball almost turned over there. Badu thinks about a second grab at it. But they take it forward with big Van Heerden.
No.
Scored a try in the first half. Now Badu again, heavily involved. So important getting those players off the bench. Cross kick here. Comes the way for Madison Hughes. He does very well there. Hughes throws it back in field. And this is Martin Josefo off the right. Josefo steamrolling players like we've seen on the Sevens World Series. Better stuff from the Eagles.
Advantage.
And then a knock-on creeps into the play.
Advantage
and Romania over. Get away with it. Their captain takes it upfield. Burcha over the halfway line. Good passage of play this. Fans are certainly being treated to some good rugby. Romania go deep, so they're going to kick. Carbon copy of the last kick. Hughes, this time can't collect. Bouncing away, and it's knocked back, and it's play on. It's Josefo with it right now. Good to see him into the action the last two movements. Holder back at 10. And then Dertalo absorbs a steaming hit as threatened. Palamo busts up the middle. Palamo flings it back in field to Holder, who looked to be grabbed there early.
Holding back.
You get a sense this game's starting to open up now, Dallin. Both teams making inroads. A couple of gaps opening up. That man Palamo did really well. Just spotted the gap through the middle. Lovely pass from him. That's difficult to do. You just see he weights that ball perfectly, turning his body completely. And Holder, well, he never had a chance there. The number two, Capitina there, had a hold of him well before Holder had a chance to catch the ball. And I have a feeling the referee may reach into his pocket here. Well, he already has and sent the guy to the naughty chair. Eugene Capitina, 10 minutes in the bin for his troubles. And this will give USA another advantage here.
But that kick hasn't gone out at all. Holder, that is a mistake and a kick he'll want back. Just when we had momentum for the USA side, Romania come back here and they will get the scrum.
Oh, that's a huge let off. What a disappointment there. Had them right where they wanted them, the US. Romania now get off the hook, but still got a little work to do now with one player in the bin. Seems like there's a momentum shift. The US now playing with their tails up. You can see the way they're defending now. They're moving off the line a lot quicker, like we mentioned before. It's a lot nicer to look at the scoreboard and see seven as opposed to nil. But again, you know that they can't dilly-dally with this Romanian team. They need to hit back and get some more points as well if there's any chance of winning this game, Dallin.
Another good look at that early tackle there. Meanwhile, replacement number 16 on the field right now, earning his 58th cap, is Andre Rodoy. He's on the pitch. Scored 25 points for the Romanian side. So we're down to 14 players.
Set!
And Romania. Stab it over the top. Chasers are there. Hughes tries to get this one. It bounces up and knocks it on. And so Lukic is all over this one. This kick is charged down again. But dangerous times here for the US under all sorts of pressure. Onto the field there is Langi Langi. Campbell from Indiana University makes that tackle.
No!
As Sabeta tries to pull players and bodies around. Romania do well at the breakdown. Even though they go backwards, they still manage to recycle possession. Very few turnovers against them. Storming tackle here from Manoa. We've seen
your
that.
Hands are on the ground.
For four Play seasons at Northampton Stay and now up. At Toulon. Well, those giving away the penalty.
Yeah, shame there, just going the extra, extra yard. He done so well with that hit. Crunching tackle there. Gets to his feet. And the referee doesn't like the look of it. He's infringed, and once again, Romania. A breathe a sigh of relief. Lakers at the moment still with man in the bin. They've got to hold on for 7 minutes and 45 seconds with one man down on the USA team.
So first line-out throw here for Rodoy. Made his debut in 2008 against the Czech Republic. The side are looking very strong at the set piece. Van Heerden. And the rolling ball comes through the middle. Romania into the 22. They come flying up on defense to the Eagles. Palamu makes a good tackle. But the Romanians still keep possession, and Rose stepping off his right foot.
Turnover's good. Hands away!
Forsberger complaining, wants to get in there, and they've drawn the penalty indeed.
Turnover was good.
Yeah, that's a result of some mounting pressure there from the US. Fantastic play. I've seen him screaming up in defense, just smothering this Romanian attack. Rose, they had nowhere to go. As a result, oh no, it's another bad mistake. Kick hasn't gone out again. Romania have kept it in the field of play.
Two in a row. You can't do that in international rugby. The US still have possession. Forsberger puts this one high. Didn't go as far as you would like. Your wind is swirling over there, and Josefa can't get a hold of that, nor can anyone else.
Once again, that's a demonstration here. Just getting the kick away there. Oh, was it a late hit? No, he's definitely committed to that tackle. No problem with that in my eyes, Dallin. But we just cast our minds back a minute earlier, unable to put that ball out from the penalty kick.
White.
Not pretty with referee, so it's going to reset this.
Numbers in, so blue can set.
Just mistakes like that. I was going to mention, Dallin, that they're well in this game. And you feel they're fighting back. Just Romanians ready to crack, and all it's going to take is just the US team a little bit more clinical play. It's little errors like that. Romania, they are a good team. They will punish you if you don't take care of those little errors.
They go to the front. Bodies on the ground, so they reshuffle them all. Up front there from Tarush.
Nine! One.
And Suruju now breaks himself. Goes across field. A beautiful little breakout here. Tangimana throws it to Umanga. And it's Romania that are cutting loose here in the second half. In from fullback, earning his 91st cap is Catalin Ferku. Space to move for them this side. Van Heerden gets the offload away. Scully asked to make a good tackle. Certainly saved something on that far side.
Sure did. Great play from Blaine
Early
Scully
tackle.
There. Somehow the Romanians had an overlap on this left side. They're doing a great job with only 14 men on the field in attack. Somehow finding the space with extra men. Scully was under pressure from his teammates. He came in trying to force the error. The ball got out to his wing, and he was able to turn around, get back out and cover that last man. Madison Hughes there as well. So good defense there from Scully and Hughes in the end. And he also come up with the ball.
Yeah.
At their 40-meter line.
I'll do the same for you as what you do to them.
Still 4 minutes left on that yellow card offense. The US have an extra man in play right now. Tafeti. He goes to the back. Nice take there from Savetta, 6'8".
16!
You'd expect the lumberjack to get those. Tafeti now with Bowman at the back.
Advantage.
McFarlane comes in with a swinging arm.
Yep, pulling it down.
And Orsberg, another tap and go. Trying to catch them unawares.
Fine.
And Lungi Lungi into play right now. What an impact he's making off the bench. All the way to the 22. Breton Palamo in to help out.
Nine, leave it!
Orsberger wants quick ball. He's getting frustrated though. Their hands and players off their feet.
No. Where we go?
Now some more great play from Augsburger. Just lifting the pace
first
of the game with a quick tap.
Second
he's had a lot of
went.
Success with it tonight. Ball didn't quite go to hand at first.
First time he was
but it was
okay.
Langy Langy picked it up and just charged forward. He made a good 30 metres for his team. Good display of patience there as well. Didn't force the pass, just made sure that the ball was placed back safely, although the Romanians made a mess of that ruck. And then you can just see, not too much of a mess. Infringing yet again. They're getting frustrated, the Romanians.
So the US has turned down 3 points, gone for the corner. Looking for points. That kick, in fact, that throw didn't look straight. It came off a hand, though, so it's play on with the US. Forsberger trying to pull some of his forwards out of the ruck. Slow ball for them. Lamasatelli. Now, Big Joe Toffetti.
No.
Forsberger hammered there. Advantage. And then come flying in there with some of the defenders. In fact, we of course know who that was. Tangi Mana, as Manoa surges for the line.
Advantage over!
This is the Eagles on the rampage here with Bowman. Looking for try number two. Manoa is just standing flat.
Use it!
He needs help. Very close. Got a man on his back, Cervetta. And now they come to Durotalo right near the poles. Just needs to get that ball in against the padding. Bodies everywhere. Got to feel that this is still short of the line or held up.
Well, was that the right option in the end? The piling on the pressure here, the US. Romanians just bound to crack any moment, but they're holding on for dear life. They're good defenders, the Romanians. I feel like the US got a little bit greedy there at that last. I think it was Taufete, a little bit of white line fever. And they were getting some success from the pick and drive.
Time's on.
But they're equally strong around that area, the Romanians. You run straight at them, they will put you down. You've got to try and find some space. I'm sure the back line is screaming for the ball out there.
Time is still on. Off.
Yet again, the Romanians stay alive and keep this deficit at 13 points. It'll be a held up ball on a 5 meter scrum to the US. And you would have to think now, surely, Dallin, still with one man down, the US, this is probably their best attacking opportunity of the night.
Blue scrum, held up.
What can they do against a powerful Romanian scrum? There's one backline player short, Lamasatelli. He's worked hard tonight.
Open up.
He returns to Saracens after today's match. It's his 20th cap as well. There'll be new faces in the team next week against Tonga for the USA. But meanwhile, there's still a lot of work to do in the last 15 minutes of this clash. Oh, the ball gets knocked through. Romania have turned this over. It's a tight head. And Romania will clear their lines here. Desperate times for them. And the US, no reward right there for that attack. So the jump step there from Holder. Tries to spark some magic. They look to hold him up. Gang tackling here. We've seen this in the Sevens World Series. And Romania putting it to good effect right now. This ball will well be a turnover. And is.
Wow, what a scrum for Romania there. It could be very significant, the final score of this game, Dallin. I mean, we've only got 14 minutes left. What a turning point. The US had the chance to score a good 5 or 7 points and get them within one score of this Romanian team to take the victory. Massive scrum from Romania has denied the US another certain try in that position. And that could be very significant. Final result of tonight, but still 14 minutes to play. Anything could happen now, Dallin.
Yeah, the US have been camped out here for the second half. There's a new faces on that team right now. Langi Langi on the side with Samu Manoa. Both big, strong units. You need them in a game like this. Could be difference makers. It's still with Romania, though. Such a plucky team. 55 caps here for the scrum off. Florin Surujan. We'll just reset this yet again.
I don't need you doing that.
And once again, in Romania's favour, just the scoreboard clock ticking away.
Let's go, scrum, please.
What we want right now.
Hi, Andrew. Hi, Andrew. You man, my word, please. Lift up.
Yeah, they'll be happy with this. 20 points to 7 they lead in front of their home crowd as Hooker Joe Tafeti looks on. And taking the field there is James Hiltebrand from Adelaide, Australia originally. He earns his fourth cap here for the USA. Played Super Rugby with the Waratahs, formerly with the Force. Oh, McFarlane comes in and makes a sterling tackle. Puts the pressure back on this Romanian side. And gets the penalty.
Great play, McFarlane.
Well done.
Just had a sniff, put the pressure on. Ball just
over here.
Skewed out there from the Romanian scrum, and McFarlane was on the job straight away like a hungry wolf. Managed to win a penalty for his team.
Six.
Great play. So, not all is lost.
Sorry.
This exchange for the US. They have a chance now
signaled.
To bring the score within 10 points, Dally.
Yeah, and did you hear that? They said they want to go for poles, and then someone wanted to change their mind. Referee Williams said, you've already signaled for the poles. And so Osberger, who was looking to attack with ball in hand, they've turned down 3 points before. And now they need to get this ball quickly. Take a last look at McFarlane's hit.
Yeah, great pressure from McFarlane.
Time's
equally supported by the rest of the pack, just coming in, piling in to win ball. Not much Romani could do there. Damage was done. So now, certain 3 points up for grabs. 12 minutes left, still plenty of time for this USA team.
Young Will Holder, 25 years of age, first lieutenant in the US Army. His kick is over, so the US now 10 points the deficit against Romania. Last 10 minutes fast approaching. The US
just
need to
please.
Score again
hold.
If they want to get a win on this fall tour.
Okay.
And Romania have played a superb first half. They've been up against it in the second. The defense has been very strong so far. And back to full strength as well. 15 against 15. Eric Fries on the field for the USA. Earns his 41st cap as Blaine Scully makes another strong surge. Osberger kick downfield is chased by Madison Hughes. Hughes comes flying up. It's a little bit deep though. Put too much pressure on.
Stop! Six!
And Romania content with playing territory. And that is another magical kick.
Absolutely was done. Just the option they needed to take there. Romania just want to keep US at bay, keep them down in their own territory. The kick wasn't a great one from Augsburger. Madison Hughes, despite all his efforts to chase the ball and put pressure on, it was way too deep for him to do that or even contest.
Hiltebrand, this will be his first line-out throw in today's game. Debuted for the Eagles in the AFC earlier this year. Also with the Manly Marlins. Good take there. Lungi Lungi steams onto this off Hughes. Now they got threatened Palamo. They get him around the bootstraps. The young player played sevens with Samoa, and then he switched to the USA, and they drag him out there. That is another strong bit of wrestling from the defensive Romanians.
Absolutely was. They've done a fantastic job, the center pairing for Romania tonight. Not giving Palamo any space. Palamo for that matter as well. Really, the only breaks that the backs have been able to make have been out in open play or counter-attack, Darwin. You see there, just really good cover defense coming across. Strong players, Palamo. It still took three or four Romanians to bring Palamo to ground and over the sideline. But that just shows the commitment and the hunger of this Romanian team right now.
Looked like he got a knee to the ground, which means he needed to release the tackle player. So a bit debatable there. Referee Kurt Reeve will be watching this game closely, analyzing it for all the USA referees. Meanwhile, some more replacements coming in for this Romania side. Off the sideline, we saw gearing ready with Valentin Popolan, as well as Valentin Talafitanu. So they take the field.
Alex, can we start?
As we near into the last 10 minutes of this clash. The crowd are certainly enjoying this lead right now. USA find themselves defending a lineout.
Okay, let's go.
Mm-hmm. The Mighty Oaks take their time. Replacement. Good catch there at the top for Popolan. Fry is in there. The ball spits backwards. So it's play on for Romania. Setting up the first phase there is Rodoy.
No!
Now they're making some ground on that far side. The ball goes backwards. So it's behind Van Heerden. He cleans things up. Does the South African-born lock forward. And then Rose with a beautiful inside pop pass. Umanga streaking onto that.
Knock on.
Advantage here for the USA Eagles after the ball spits loose. And they will try run from deep. Over the top it comes to Palermo, stepping off that right foot of his into open space. He gets Bryce Campbell with him. Campbell strong in support. And then diving over the top, surely it's got to be cynical play.
We're going back.
Sent to the bin in my book.
I'd have to agree with that, Dallin, but looks like the referee is going to come back to the original infringement. Full time off. He's now battered and bruised. You see the last incident there. As you mentioned, Alan, just a professional foul. The referee obviously pulled it up straight away, but he has something else in his mind right now.
So it's going to be a penalty to you here for a late tackle against six. Six, we're going back. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, you're totally right. He's picked something up before that incident. It's going to be a penalty
tackle,
to Romania for a cold shoulder. He's not using the arms.
So
and there it is on Rose McFarlane.
Thanks,
looks okay in my book.
Yeah, me too, darling. He's possibly calling it. Was he calling it late or just not wrapping? Either way, he deserved that result for either, but nonetheless. Now with Romania, doing a great job just shutting out this USA team right now, but it's not over. 7.5 minutes left to play. The US showing some great confidence coming out of their zone there before the referee picked them up for the infringement earlier on. There's Palermo there stepping, such a big man, great feet for a big guy. It's a shame we haven't seen him in more space tonight.
Well, you have to play for the USA Sevens team if you want to play 15s in the back line. Six out of seven backline players here, and then coming off the bench as well. So many talented stars, and really that goes to show Mike Friday working hand in hand with John Mitchell. Both programs of 15s and 7s interrelated. And meanwhile, Romania let the time tick away as their most capped ever player, Flaicu. Flaicu's kick brings smiles to the fans, and they're up 23-10 with 6.5 minutes to play here in Bucharest.
Flaicu, a kick. See there, the breeze obviously coming back into his face. Didn't perturb him though. Lovely strike.
Yeah, bring him on.
And now, somehow, Romania get another 3 points on the board against the US. Running out of time, the US Eagles need to hit back and keep ball in hand.
Okay. Well, I expect some of the Sevens maestros to put their hands up here. Will Holder, he's one of them. His kick comes down to Martin Yosefo. That's a Sevens move right there. It's gone backwards, picked up by Campbell. Great work from both those two players. It's inside the 22. It's what the USA want right now. Romania better be careful for infringing. In my book, there is certainly some cynical play slowing things down that needs to go punished. They take it for the line with Samu. Fry wants to be the next receiver. Goes behind his back. And they've got Palermo throws it over the top. The Yurtu is on the field as well. The debutant off the bench. Ty Leotu. And now McFarlane taps and goes. They've got Hiltebrand. Low center of gravity. Holder. This is great stuff from the USA. Campbell puts the shoulder down, looking to make the ESPN highlights yet again. Quick ball for the Eagles in the midfield. Holder spots space out wide. Oh, and couldn't be collected. There's a couple of non-rugby players on the field there. It's chaos all around, and you've got to feel like referee has got to get them off and keep possession with the US.
Yeah, that was tough to see. Clearly, a lot of traffic out there. Were they in the way of that play? Because you can bet your bottom dollar that the pass from Holder, you probably saw the trainer of the Romanian team in his sights as well. It just makes for a bit of chaos, but it doesn't look like the referee is... He's going to stick with his original decision of the knock-on, Dallin. That's a tough blow for the US. Such a great lead-up play as well. Wonderful hands from the backs.
Knock-on blue, scrum yellow.
Romania just holding on for dear life.
Well, they had 17 Romanias on defense there, with a couple of extras from the sideline. So it will be the home side as we wind down into the last 5 minutes of this game. The US need 2 converted tries to win this match. They've got a turnover possession right now. Putting in is Kalafatanu, 86 caps off the bench. Reserve scrum off. They have a highly experienced team. As that scrum just melts the US away. Kick downfield is another good one. The kicking game has been excellent. As Lyoto comes in and feeds Hughes. Hughes will have to launch a counterattack from deep. He's got Yosefo beats 2. Still going. His pass has been intercepted by Jody Rose, and that's what happens when you're chasing the game. You have to fling some of those 50-50 passes, and now Romania find themselves well inside U.S. territory. Quick hand to the outside. Rose throws it back in field, and Lukac, first half try scorer, is into play yet again. He's had a sterling performance at 6. It's a penalty to the U.S. They've got to go quickly. 3.5 minutes left. There's no time here.
6. Too far.
To kick.
Too far. Right here. Holding on.
Romania doing a great job of just keeping the U.S. in their own territory. As we see, they did elect for the kick. Dallin, they want to line out. Play off some set piece here. They've got quite a few yards to make up.
Let's see what they can do here. Forwards are sucked in on this side of the field. So the backs take it up, and Langi actually, short lineup.
No,
he was
no.
in the midfield. That's who you want to give it to, Manoa or Langi. And now Lama Sotelli with Fry on his back.
Leave it.
Ball has to go backwards there to be picked up off the bench. There is Lyoto, the 26-year-old, earning his first cap tonight. What a proud moment. He had a great tournament in Uruguay recently with the selects. Former San Jose Seahawk player. As he gets out of that ruck right now. Orsberger, they've got to move it away quickly if they can. This is better shape. Hughes, and then the ball's been knocked. Half intercepted there from Jody Rose. Rose has come away with it this time. Oh, and then he gets monstered in the tackle.
Deliberate.
That was Langi, of course. He's lost a scrum cap.
Deliberate knock on.
He's just been ferocious since coming off the bench.
Crunching tackle, Langi. But just still, again, well, US go quickly.
Oh, they do. This time they know that there's precious moments left on the clock as Madison Hughes gets a breakout, the Sevens captain. Onto the ball is Yosefo. Yosefo into the thick traffic. Does really well to keep it alive. Eric Fry. The US upping the tempo. Ball comes wide here to Duratalo. Throws it in field.
Play
still
on.
With Campbell. This is an exciting passage of play for the Eagles.
This player, off your feet.
Penalty. They're not 10 meters, surely. Orsberger tackled about 5 or 6 steps away. Referee says play on. And that certainly, he's got that call wrong. Romania will boot this downfield. And the United States can certainly be upset about that decision. But it's too little, too late for them as well. Just over a minute left.
Is that full time?
I'm just listening here to the referee, but you're absolutely right, Dallin. Questionable call there.
What?
US just frustrated. Despite their
full
best
time?
Efforts, Romania that doing a great
time.
Job. I mean, they're all over the place in defense, but they're doing enough just to upset the Americans. Referee calling full time. Wow.
Well, the stadium clock had another minute to go, so Paul Williams puts an end to this test match. And what a game from the home side, Romania. They have scored 3 tries to the USA's 1. So thanks for joining us. for this USA Eagles test match in Bucharest, where Romania have defeated the USA Eagles by a score of 23-10. Be sure to tune in next week on Saturday, November 19th at 11 a.m. Eastern, when the United States faces off against Tonga in San Sebastian, Spain, live on the Rugby Channel. For Mark Stabina, I'm Dallin Stanford saying thanks for tuning in. This has been a copyright broadcast of Rugby International Marketing.